Hello, my name is Jason Johnson. Thank you for watching my videos. This video is going to be using advanced arrays with Raptor, and we're going to create a grading program that allows it's going to generate random questions, and then it's going to allow the user to answer those questions in the exam and then grade that exam. So let's take a look. So what we're going to do is we're going to tell the user that this is a math test, and we're going to set our variables. So first we're going to go to our subchart variables, and we've got a lot of variables here, but we've thought through this, and we know that we need to have various numbers and answers and questions. So we're going to set our x to 10 because we want to have 10 questions. We want to set our number 1 x to 0, our number 2 x to 0, our answers to 0. We're going to set our questions to blank. We're going to set our count to 1. We're going to set our responses to 0. We're going to set our wrong count to 0. And we're going to set our incorrect x value to 0. And then we're going to set our score to 0. And then it's going to end this subchart. It's going to come back to the main. And then it's going to load our questions. Now, what we're going to do with our questions here is we're going to create a loop, and it's going to generate random numbers. And it's going to say on the number 1 count, we're going to set the floor, and we're going to say random from 100. From 1 to 100, so it's going to generate the number 1 from 1 to 100, and then it's going to generate the number 2 from 1 to 100, and then it's going to say what is the answer between those two. So it's going to take number 1 plus number 2, and what is that answer, because we're going to use addition on this exam. We could use subtraction, but we're going to use addition on this one, but you could do different types of math in here. So we're going to set our answers, and then we're going to set our questions count, and it's going to create each one of these, and it's going to say, it's going to create a question. What is number 1 plus number 2, and then question mark, and it's going to set the count to 1 until it gets up to 10. Is the count greater than x? And our x was set to 10. We set our x to 10, or when our count gets to 10. Count is greater than x, yeah. And our x was set to 10 right here. See, x was set to 10. So when x is greater than 10, it'll kick out and end. It'll come back over to main, and it'll say, now let's take the test. So after it's created the variables, loaded the question, we're going to take the test. The user is going to come in, and it's going to come over to the subchart for the test, and it's going to set the count to 1. It's going to do a loop here, and it's going to check to see, is the count greater than x? Because, again, we want to count to 10. And it's going to say here, and it's going to say questions, and it's going to use the arrays that we created. You'll see those here in a few minutes on the left-hand side. And it's going to say, get the response from the user, and it's going to set the count, and it's going to record all of those responses for each question. It's going to output to the user, and it's going to say, what is number 1 plus number 2, number 1 plus number 2, and it's going to go through that 10 times. It's going to end that, and then it's going to say, let's grade the test. So then it's going to come over here, and it's going to grade the test. We're going to, again, set our count to 1. We're going to start a loop here, and we're going to check again to say, make sure our count is 10, 1 to 10. And it's going to say, set the response count, is it not equal to the answers? So is response count not equal to the answer? If it's not, it's going to say that's an incorrect count. And then if it is, it's going to say incorrect count for the questions, and it's going to count that one as wrong, and then it's going to set the count. If it's not, it's going to give the correct answer and put that into the array, and it'll continue to do that until it checks all of the answers. Then it's going to come back over to the main, and then it's going to go display results, and then this is going to output the array information out to the user. It's going to say, what is your score? So it's going to say x minus the wrong divided by x times 100. Then it'll give us that percentage, and it'll say, you got what wrong out of x problems, and then it'll say, these are the questions you got wrong, and you'll see in the array here in a minute, it will record the answers or the questions that were incorrect, and then it will set the count to 1, it'll loop through, and then it'll count to x, and it'll check the incorrect count, and then put the questions for the count, and put those out to the user, and then until it gets to 10, and then kick on out. So let's slow this down just a little bit, and let's go ahead. I'm going to do step-by-step on this one, so we can see what is happening here. So we're outputting to the user, this is a math test. We're gonna set our variables. I'm gonna go to this pretty quick, but then as we get back to the main here, before we load our questions, I'm gonna show you the different arrays that we have created here on our variables. We created all these different arrays here. And we created a response. So we created a response for a size of 10. our questions for a size of 10, number 2 for a size of 10, number 1 for a size of 10, our incorrect responses for a size of 10, and then our answers. And then now we need to go and generate our questions. So we're going to click next, and it's going to loop through, and it's going to create our first one, and it's created our number, our numbers here. So it's going to create number 1 is 35, and number 1 is 4, and number 2 is 35. These are the random numbers that it's generating. And then it's going to set our question, and then it's going to take these values, what is 4 plus 35, see? So it's created, and it's going to store that in the questions area. And then it's just going to continue to loop around and do that until we get 10 questions. So it's just going to keep going. I'm going to put a toggle breakpoint right there. Well, because I'm not running this full speed, I don't need a toggle breakpoint there, but we'll just run that. And then it's going to come, and it kicked out because our count got to 10, right? So our count got to 10, and it's going to kick out, and it's going to come back over here to our main. And now we're going to take the test. So now the user is going to come in, and it's going to set the count to 1 again. See, our count will be set to 1 right here. It's set to 11. Now it's going to clear it and make it back to 1 again. And then now it's going to go into this loop, and it's going to check the count. It's under 10, so it's going to come here, and it's going to say, this is going to output to the user, and it's going to take the value of the first two, number 1 and number 2, and say, what is 4 plus 35? And we're going to put our value in here, and I'm going to go up here and show you. These are our answers, because it recorded our answers. It took the 4 plus 35 and added that together and created an array with all of our answers so that we can check that later. So now it's going to store all of these responses in the response array. And I'm going to put some of these in incorrect, and I'm going to put some of them in as correct. This first one I'm going to put in 39. It's going to go around, and it's going to ask us what our next one is. And this 105, but I'm going to put 104. I'm going to make that one wrong. And then it's going to come again, and 109, let's make that one correct. And let's go again, and we'll make that one 37. That one will be correct. And we'll come around again. We'll make that one 155. We'll make that one correct. And then let's make this one 42. Make that one incorrect. This one will be 100. This one will be 116. This one will be 57, but we're going to make that wrong. And then this one will be 24. 12 plus 12 is 24. And then it was going to catch our count now, and it's going to say count is 11, so it's greater than X, which is 10. So it's going to kick out, and it's going to come back to the main, and now it's going to grade our test. So it's going to take what our answers were, what did our user put in for answers, and it's going to compare those two. It's going to compare those two. It's going to take our responses here and compare those to the answers. So it's going to just go through each one of those. It's going to set our count back to 1. It's going to loop here, and it's going to say, you know, our count. And then it's going to check, and it's going to say is, and this is, it's going to create an array here for incorrect. And this one was okay because the response count, what was in the response count here for array 1 matched what was in the answers, or the answers matched. So answers did, so it did, so it matched. I'm not saying that right. It did match, so it kicked out and it set the count to 1, and then it put our response of okay. So response count did equal answers. See, it's saying did not equals answers. It would kick over to yes, but this one did equal answers. So it's kicking out, and it's saying put the response of okay into the incorrect array. So incorrect now for number 1 is okay, and it's just going to go through each one of these. And you'll notice in the array for incorrect, the ones that were incorrect, because it kicked out and said the response count does not equal answers, yes. So it's going to say incorrect, and then it's going to say what was the wrong plus 1. Because it's going to say wrong plus 1, because we need to increase our wrong. But it's also going to put into the array incorrect of what the questions were. So see, it's saying what is 72 plus 33, because we're going to output that to the user here in just a few minutes. And then it's going to get to number 10, and then it's going to display the results, and it's going to come over here, and it's going to do our scoring, and it's going to say our score is down here is 70. Because we missed 3. See, we missed 3. And It's going to say you got 70%. You got 3 wrong out of 10. Because see, we've got that down here. There was 3 wrong and we had 10 total. And then it's going to say these are the questions you got wrong. And now it's going to output the results of the incorrect array. And it's not going to output the okay. It's not going to output the okay. See, if it's equal to okay, no. Or if it's not equal to okay, it'll say no and it won't add to that. But if it is not equal to okay, then it will put the response to that out of that array. So it's going to go through and it's going to count now. It's going to go through the incorrect array and it's going to put those 3 answers that we missed or 3 questions that we missed. 72, 38, 26 right there. And then now it's going to finish up. It's going to end the program and we're done. So I hope this video was helpful for you. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. If you are one of my students, you can email me and I hope you have a great day. Be excellent to each other.